Hello students, in this video we are going to learn the second segment of the lesson Health and Diseases. In the first segment we have learned about the different types of abuses and their prevention and protection from the child sexual abuse, the causes of drugs, tobacco and alcohol addiction and its ill effects and all the possible ways of de-addiction. Now in this video we are going to learn about the diseases and disorders due to lifestyle modification. Diseases are more prevalent in our society due to our improper way of living, stress and strain conditions. And these diseases are termed as non-communicable diseases. These diseases cause impairment in the body tissue or organs and cause disturbances in the metabolic functions which are required for the modification of an individual's normal life. First disease of such type is diabetes mellitus. Diabetes mellitus is a chronic metabolic disorder. In Greek, diabetes means running through and mellitus means sweet. It is characterized by the increase in the blood sugar level or glucose level. And this increase is caused due to the insufficient or failure of insulin secretion by the pancreas. Insulin is secreted by the endocrine gland called pancreas. But diabetes mellitus is increasing worldwide and it is of two types. They are type 1 and type 2. The type 1 diabetes mellitus is called insulin dependent diabetes mellitus and it accounts for about 10-20% of the total diabetic patients. Juvenile onset diabetes is called insulin dependent diabetes mellitus. It occurs in children and young adults. The onset is usually sudden and it can be life threatening also. It is caused due to the destruction of the beta cells of the pancreas. The beta cells of the pancreas only secrete the insulin. Because of their destruction, the insulin is not secreted. It is not secreted adequately. And because of that, there will be an abnormal elevated glucose level in the blood, resulting in hyperglycemia. The causes of this disease can be of genetic inheritance. It can be transmitted from the parents to the children, or it can be of environmental factor, because of environmental factors like infection due to virus, acute stress, etc. Second type of diabetes mellitus is called as non-insulin dependent diabetes mellitus. It is otherwise called as adult onset diabetes and it accounts for about 80-90% of the total diabetic population. It develops very slowly and usually milder but more stable. Insulin production of the pancreas will be normal. The insulin circulation in the blood will be normal, but the target cell will not respond to the circulating insulin in the blood. In this condition, it will not allow the glucose to enter. It will not allow the glucose molecules to enter into the cell. Causes for this disease are multifactorial, which include increase of age, because it affects the middle-aged people and the older age people, obesity, sedentary lifestyle, overeating. When the people are physically inactive, they are more prone to this non-insulin dependent diabetes mellitus. What are the symptoms of diabetes mellitus? It is associated with the several metabolic alterations. The most important symptoms are, first, increase in the blood glucose level. This condition is called as hyperglycemia. This causes increased urine output. Increase in the blood glucose level causes increased urine output, which is called as polyuria. This leads to dehydration or loss of water from the body. Loss of water from the body leads to thirst, that is polydipsia. Polydipsia results in the increased fluid intake. People will drink more of water. Excessive water intake will lead to excess excretion of the urine along with glucose in it, and this condition is called as glycosuria. Excess elimination of urine along with glucose causes excess hunger. which is called as polyphagia. Polyphagia is caused due to the loss of glucose in the urine, and this in turn causes fatigue or tiredness and loss of weight. How to prevent and control diabetes? People should be very careful in having their diet, proper diet, by consuming hypoglycemic drugs, insulin injection and exercise are the options to control and prevent the severity of this condition. The overall goal of the diabetes management is to maintain the normal blood glucose level. Dietary management. So how should be the diet? The person who is having diabetes mellitus, how should they eat? What and all they can eat? They should take low carbohydrate content food, fiber rich food. Carbohydrate should be taken in the form of starch and complex sugars only. They should avoid the sugars in the form of sucrose and glucose. It should not be taken. And diet must comprise of whole grains, millets like jowar, bajra, rahi, green leafy vegetables, wheat and unpolished rice can be taken in their diet regularly. Their carbohydrate content must be maintained about 50 to 55% of total calories. And they should have 10 to 15% of protein, which contains essential amino acid. They can take a fat up to 15 to 25% of their total calories. Saturated fat intake must be reduced rather than the polyunsaturated fatty acids. Polyunsaturated fatty acid can be higher, should be higher. Management with insulin. Commercially available insulin preparation, which is in the form of injection, can be used to maintain the blood glucose level. Physical activity, exercise plays a very important role in controlling the diabetes. In addition to the strengthening and the toning up of the muscle, it controls the diabetes to a very great extent. People must be given awareness. They must be educated on the nature of the disease and the possibilities of the complications of the disease. And if the blood sugar is not kept under the control, it causes lot of malfunctioning of the organs. And so instruction regarding the diet, exercise, drugs must be given, explained to them. The next condition is called as obesity. Obesity is a state in which there is an excessive accumulation of fat in the body, with an abnormal increase in the body weight. So obesity is also a complex multifactorial chronic disease that influences social, behavioral, psychological, metabolic and cellular factors. If the intake of the calories is more than the expenditure, it causes obesity. So overweight and obesity are the condition in the person whose body weight is greater than the mean standard weight for age and height of the individual. And it can be calculated by body mass index, BMI in short, by which we can estimate the body fat and the health risk. So BMI can be calculated by dividing the weight of the person in kg by height in meter square. What are the causes and risks for this obesity? So obesity may be caused due to genetic factors, physical inactivity, eating habits like overeating, and due to hormonal factors like endocrine factors. Obesity can cause hypertension, diabetes, gallbladder disease, coronary heart diseases and arthritis. So how to prevent and control this obesity? By dietary management. So obese person should consume only low calorie food which contains normal protein, vitamins, minerals, restricted carbohydrate and fat. They can intake high fiber diet to prevent the overweight. Physical exercise must be done. Low calorie diet accompanied by the moderate exercise will be very effective to lose their weight. And along with the exercise, meditation, yoga, physical activity can also reduce the stress related to the overeating. Heart diseases, cardiovascular disease or CVD, which is associated with the heart and the blood vessels. Coronary heart disease is the most common form. Coronary artery is the artery that supply the blood to the heart muscles. the CHD or the coronary artery disease is developed slowly over many years, beginning from their childhood. So it may be caused due to the formation of a fatty streak to a fibrous complicated plaque inside the inner wall of their blood vessels, and this leads to the narrowing of the blood vessels, leading to atherosclerosis. So the atherosclerosis will cause the block in the supply of the blood in the arteries that supply the heart muscles with oxygen. This leads to a sudden ischemia. Ischemia means deficient blood supply to the heart muscles. Because of that, the muscles will suffer and causes myocardial infarction. That is, death of the heart muscular tissue take place. Death of the heart muscles take place. Risk factors of heart diseases: hypercholesterolemia, that is high blood cholesterol level, high blood pressure, which is called hypertension, are the major causes and contributing factors of heart disease. And if it is untreated, it may cause severe damage to the brain, kidney, and eventually leads to the stroke and death. What are the causes of heart diseases? Mainly heredity. It is transferred from parents to children through genes, and a diet which is rich in saturated fat and cholesterol, obesity, increasing age, cigarette smoking, emotional stress, sedentary lifestyle, excessive alcohol consumption, and lack of physical activity. Symptoms of heart diseases are the shortness of breath first, then headache, tiredness, dizziness, chest pain, swelling of legs, and gastrointestinal disturbances. How to prevent and control the heart disease? So reduce the intake of the calories, low saturated fat, and cholesterol rich food. Low carbohydrate and common salts are some dietary modifications. So salt must be taken less, as well as carbohydrate and salt must be taken very less. Instead, diet which is rich in polyunsaturated fatty acid, that is PUFA, can be taken. Increase the intake of fiber rich food. Fruits, vegetables, proteins, minerals, and vitamins can be taken. So along with the diet management, regular exercise, walking, yoga are essential to maintain the body weight. Addictive substances like alcohol consumption and smoking must be strictly avoided. Cancer. Cancer causes nearly 4 million deaths every year throughout the world. In India, more than 1 million people suffer from cancer. Cancer is derived from a Latin word meaning crab. And the study of cancer is called oncology. Oncos means tumor. Cancer is an abnormal and uncontrolled division of the cell. And this will invade and destroy the surrounding tissue, which forms the tumor, which is otherwise called neoplasm, which means new growth. Some cells do not respond to the normal cell division. Instead, they grow in a different pattern, causing cancer. The cancer cell will detach from the place of origin and they migrate to distant parts of the body and affect new tissues. And this process is called metastasis. Metastasis happen in the lungs, bones, liver, skin, and brain tissues. The difference between the normal and the cancer cells. So this side you can see the normal, whereas the cancer cells, they will be larger and will have variably shaped nucleus, whereas the normal cells will have uniformly shaped nucleus and they will be smaller in size. And these cells, cancer cells, will be dividing always, and they will divide and they are not arranged in an organized manner, whereas the normal cells divide and they will be arranged in an organized manner. And the cancer cells, the size and the shape will vary, but the size of the normal cells will be similar in a tissue. And the cancer cells will lose the normal features and become tumors. What are the types of cancer? First one is carcinomas. Carcinomas arise from the epithelial or the lining tissue and the glandular tissues. And they include cancers of the skin, lung, stomach, and brain. About 85% of the tumor are carcinomas. Secondly, sarcomas. Sarcomas occur in the connective and the muscular tissue. So they include the cancers of bone, cartilage, tendons, adipose tissue, and muscles. And they form just 1% of all tumors. Thirdly, leukemia. It is characterized by an increase in the formation of the white blood cells. So suddenly there will be a shoot up in the number of white blood cells, WBC, in the bone marrow and the lymph nodes. and this causes leukemia. So leukemia is otherwise called blood cancer. This is the most common type of cancer, which also affects the children who are below 18 years of age. Carcinogenic agents are the cancer causing agents. There are physical agents, chemical agents, ionizing radiation and biological agents. Physical irritants. Heavy smoking causes lung cancer, cancers of the oral cavity, that is mouth, pharynx, throat and larynx, or due to physical irritants that are the products of smoking tobacco leaf. Beetle and tobacco chewing also causes oral cancer. Excessive exposure to sunlight may cause skin cancer. Some of the chemical agents are nicotine, caffeine, products of the combustion of coal and oil, pesticide, asbestos, nickel, certain dyes and artificial sweetener induce cancer in the body. Radiations like ionizing radiations like X-rays, gamma rays, radioactive substances, and non-ionizing radiations like UV rays damage DNA of the cells, causing cancer. The biological agents are the viruses. Infection of certain viruses causes cancer, and these viruses are called oncogenic viruses. How to treat the cancer? So surgery is the first method. Tumors can be removed by surgery to prevent further spread of the cancer cells. Secondly, radiation therapy. The tumor cells are irradiated by lethal dosage of radiation, and it will protect the surrounding normal cells. Cancer cells alone will be destroyed. Secondly, chemotherapy. This involves the administration of the anti-cancerous drugs, medicine, and this will prevent the cell division, and they are used to kill the cancer cells also. Thirdly, immunotherapy. The antiviral proteins like interferons, which are used as the biological response modifiers to activate the immune system of our body, by which we can destroy the tumor cells. This is called immunotherapy. Preventive measures of cancer. Cancer must be identified, diagnosed in the early stage, because in later stage, even if it is diagnosed, it cannot be cured. So cancer control program should focus on the primary prevention and early detection. Lung cancer can be prevented by avoiding smoking. Stop smoking because it causes lung cancer. And the individual should not be exposed to toxic pollutants of the industries, since they cause cancer. People should avoid exposing themselves to the toxic pollutants of the industries to avoid cancer. And exposure to excessive radiation also causes skin cancer. Excessive exposure to the radiation also should be avoided to prevent the skin cancer. AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. AIDS is a severe viral disease. It is caused by the infection of the virus called human immunodeficiency virus. It is a condition in which the person's immune system fails, and it suppresses the body's disease fighting mechanism. Since these viruses attack the lymphocytes and kill them, the affected individual are more prone to the infectious diseases. The affected individual become deficient of the immunity, and they are more prone to the infectious diseases. Transmission of HIV virus. HIV virus has been found in the urine, tears, saliva, breast milk and vaginal secretion of the affected individual. And so these viruses are transmitted from the infected person who comes in contact with the blood of a healthy person. So AIDS is not transmitted by touching or any physical contact, but it spread through the contacts of the body fluids or blood. HIV is transmitted generally by sexual contact with the infected person, use of the contaminated needles and syringe, especially in case of intravenous drug abuses. Thirdly, by the transfusion of the contaminated or infected blood and blood products to the normal person. Can also get transmitted from the infected mother to the child through placenta. So HIV can be transmitted by sexual contact, sharing the needles, by the drug abuses from mother to the baby during pregnancy, and by breastfeeding. Symptoms and treatment of disease AIDS. The infected individual become immunodeficient. These persons become more susceptible to all sort of infections like viral, bacteria and protozoan, fungal infection. There will be swelling of their lymph nodes due to the infection. The HIV infection causes damage to the brain. They lose their memory, lack of appetite, weight loss, fever. They will have chronic diarrhea, cough, lethargy, pharyngitis, inflammation in the pharynx, nausea and headache. These are the symptoms of the HIV patients or AIDS patient. How it can be diagnosed? The presence of HIV virus can be confirmed by the Western blot test or enzyme-linked immunosorbent assay, that is ELISA test. The treatment includes administering antiretroviral drugs or immunostimulative therapy can prolong the life of the infected person. Prevention and control of AIDS. Screening of the blood. Screening of blood from the blood banks for HIV before transfusion must be done. Ensure the use of disposable needles and syringes in the hospitals and clinics. Advocating safe sex and using condoms. Creating awareness campaign and educating the people on the consequences of the AIDS. Persons with the AIDS should not be isolated from the family and the society.